Without the second law of thermodynamics, we could just as easily live in a universe where life never existed, due to the fact that the entropy of the universe had always been and will always continue to be at the maximum possible value. And in fact, that is what would be the most likely scenario if each set of possible initial conditions was equally likely. If each set of starting conditions was equally likely to occur, then the starting conditions which we would most likely get is one in which the entropy was already at the maximum possible value to begin with. Let us recall that with the exception of the second law of thermodynamics, all the other laws of physics work the same way both backwards and forwards in time. That is, if you reverse the direction of the particles and then follow the laws of physics, you will get the same outcome in reverse order. Therefore, if we know a set of initial conditions, we can use the laws of physics to run a simulation forward in time to predict the future, or we can use the laws of physics to run a simulation backwards in time to determine the past. If every set of initial conditions is equally likely in a physics simulation, there are two types of initial conditions that would be extremely unlikely to occur. The first of these two extremely unlikely scenarios is a random set of initial conditions where, if you run the simulation forward in time, the entropy would decrease as a result. The second of these two extremely unlikely scenarios is a random set of initial conditions where the entropy would decrease as you run the simulation backwards in time. The second of these scenarios is equally unlikely to the first. Yet, this second scenario is precisely the universe we live in. Since all the other laws of physics are symmetrical with regards to time, a universe in which the entropy constantly increases with time is no more likely than a universe in which the entropy constantly decreases with time. This is why the second law of thermodynamics says something very profound about the initial conditions of the universe, and this could never be derived from the other known laws of physics. The second law of thermodynamics can therefore be viewed as a statement about the initial conditions of the universe and about the initial conditions of every subset of the universe.